Now, let's have a look at what is Maven. So Maven, in its simplest term, is a build automation tool. Well, it's also used for project management. And so who manages Maven or who developed it? So it was developed by Apache Foundation, and it was an advanced tool which was built on top of Ant. So Ant was the first build tool which was developed by Apache, and then they developed Maven, which is much advanced and have a lot of features which are not in Ant presently. The most important part, it's an open source tool and it's freely available. Like all the plugins are built by the online different online communities. There are lots of remote repositories, lots of external repositories which are available, which can be used for maintaining your dependencies. Now, coming to Maven. So, as I said, it's a build automation tool, or in simple terms, it's a build tool. And everything coming out of Maven is generally an artifact. So for example, if you are building a jar file for your project, so Maven produces the jar file or a WAR file. So there are different kinds of artifacts which are which can be produced by a Maven project. It can also be a dependency POM, where that POM file could be used for another project. So there is the reusability factor which is provided by Maven, when it can reproduce those artifacts and those project information, which is essential for releases, right? So it also manages all the dependencies of your project. So in earlier days, we used to manage all our project requirements or dependencies in the form of jar files within our project. Now, if it's a small project, it's very easy to manage those dependencies. But as the project grows and you continue to work on it, there will be thousands and thousands of dependencies which might require which might be required in a project, and it's virtually impossible to manage them individually. So that's where Maven comes in, and it helps to manage all our dependencies with the help of a single pom.xml file. As I said earlier, it's also a project management tool because it helps us to version our code. So our project could have a number of different versions, like 1.0 or 2.0, or it could be a development version as well, like 1.0 snapshot, 2.0 snapshot. And this makes our releasing much easier, because we can release different versions of our same project and we can build it continuously, right? We can also produce a lot of different documentation, like documentation for our site using different plugins. Also, we can produce Java docs for our source code. So there's a lot of management which we can do using Maven for our projects. Now, why use Maven? As I said, we can build continuously using Maven, right? So it is very helpful when you are working in a DevOps environment, where you're part of the continuous integration and continuous deployment teams, where you need to produce a number of builds over and over again. So without changing any configuration, with the help of Maven, we can build continuously. The next advantage of using Maven is it's very easy to set up. You just use the basic structure of Maven and everything itself falls in place. So we can easily set up in any IDE, any operating system, any platform. The next topic is the transitive dependencies. So Maven helps you to manage your dependencies and also all the other dependencies which are dependent on your parent dependency. So if you are downloading a particular dependency, there are a lot of other things which you need to download in order for that dependency to work. So which is in the form of the jar files. So Maven does all the work behind for you, and you don't need to manually go and look out for all those dependencies which are dependent on your dependency which you're going to use in your project. So that's the power of Maven. Now the next point is local repository. Well, as I was talking, managing dependencies is a big headache when you're working on large projects. So using the concept of local repository, which is nothing but a directory in your local where Maven stores, Maven downloads all the dependencies and all the things which are required for those dependencies at your local. So what happens, you don't need to download them again when you're building your project. And you can reuse those for your other projects as well. So if you're not using Maven, you need to download your dependencies again and again for 20 different projects, and it could buckle up a lot of space and it could fully burst your computer or your machine, right? So in terms of memory management and also in terms of disk space, Maven helps you save a lot of space because it will only download those dependencies once, and it could be reused in different projects. Now, the next point is it has got seamless integration across all the IDEs, Mate, Eclipse, IntelliJ IDEA, or NetBeans. So any IDE, it has got seamless integration across. So it becomes very easy to use. The next point, which we already discussed, is it's a preferred tool for continuous integration, like Jenkins, TeamCity, Hudson. So there are a number of tools which are used for continuous integration and continuous deployment. And Maven is the preferred tool for all these other tools which are used in the DevOps pipeline. So being the most popular tool, it has also got a lot of features, which we can see here. And that's why Maven is widely used across the industry. So in the next video, let's look at what is the difference between Maven and other build automation tools like Ant.